Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how we can copy objects in Java. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. All right, everybody, I'm going to teach you all how we can copy objects in Java. Here's an example of the setup that I have so far. We're going to be copying some car objects. And I have an additional class called car, and we're going to be using some encapsulation in this video based on the last video on encapsulation. So we have some private variables, a private make, model, and year. We have a constructor for this car, and when we receive each of these arguments, we're going to call the appropriate setter method to assign each of these values. And we have some getter methods as well for each of these values in case we want to get them. Here's what I'm doing within my main method. I have created two cars, car1 and car2. Car1 is a Chevy Camaro, the year is 2021. Car2 is a Ford Mustang, the year is 2022. I'm going to be first printing the addresses of car1 and car2, where these objects are stored in memory, as well as all of car1's attributes, the make, the model, and the year using the getter methods, and car2's make, model, and year using the getter methods as well. So this is what we have. These are the addresses of these two objects. Car1 has an address of this in memory. Car2 has an address of this in memory. Here are all of Car1's attributes. It's a Chevy Camaro, the year is 2021, which we stated here. And our second car is a Ford Mustang, the year is 2022. And we just displayed all of the attributes using the appropriate getter methods. Let's say that we would like to copy the values from Car1 over to Car2. And a common misconception that people might do or write is that they would write something like this. Car2 equals car1, and you do not want to do this. Here's why. So with these two addresses of these cars, they now have the same address, and it appears that these values copied over. Well, that's because car2 and car1 are now the same exact car because they have the same address. What we actually did was give car1 two different names. For all intents and purposes, car1 is referred to as both car1 and car2 because they share the same address in memory. So even though it appears that these values have copied over, they're really just pointing to the same car in memory. So we're not going to be stating car2 equals car1. We're going to be creating a copy method within our car class to assign the values from car1 and apply them to car2. So let's create a copy method, but first we'll want to call this. So this will look something like this, car2.copy, and we're going to pass in the object that we want to copy. We would like to pass in car1. So we're sending a car object as an argument to this method. Now we need to set up this method within the car class. So let's go to our car class and create a copy method. Public void, it's not returning anything, and we will call this copy, and this takes one argument. This will take a car object as an argument, so we'll just call this car x. And what we have to do within this method is copy the attributes from car1 over to car2. And this is how we can do that. So we can use the this keyword. Right now we're referring to car2 because car2 is the object that has called this method. So this refers to car2. This, and we're going to use the setters. Set make, set model, and set year. So this dot set make, this dot set model, and this dot set year. Now we need to get the values of car x. That's the car that we passed in, car1. So within the arguments of each of these methods, we're going to state x dot get make, as well as x.getModel, and lastly, x.getYear. And that's all there is to it. So if we head back to our main method and run this, these cars now have two different addresses in memory, so they are both different cars, but they have the same attributes. They're both Chevy Camaros, and the year is 2021. Here's a scenario. So what if we would like to copy the values from one car and apply them to another, but this time we'll do it when we instantiate the car instead of after the fact. So for this example, let's turn these two lines into a comment. And what we're going to be doing is creating something called a copy constructor. So let's instantiate car2 like we normally would. So car2 equals new car. But within the constructor of our car, we're going to pass in car1 as an argument and make a copy of this. So we're going to be using some overloaded constructors, and the second constructor is going to be the copy constructor. So car, the parameter is a car object. So we passed in a car as an argument, and we have to set up the parameter for our car copy constructor. So this will take a car and we'll call this x. So we would like to take the values of car x and apply them to the values of our new car when we construct it. Luckily, we already have a copy method to take care of that, so it's just a matter of calling this method from within the constructor. So this.copy, and we're going to make a copy of car x that we receive when we call the car constructor. So this will do the same thing as it did before. These are two different cars, but they all have the same values. The difference is that we assigned the values from car1 and applied them to car2 when we constructed this car object. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's the basics of copying objects in Java. If you would like a copy of all this code, I will post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's how to copy objects in Java. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button. Drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.